Good morning, viewers. Welcome to Cakeman Broadcasting Center. My name is Mrs. Mpambi, and I'll be taking you for agriculture lesson this Thursday, 22nd of April. Let's meet the class. Good morning, class.
Good morning, Mrs. Mpambi.
How are you today?
Fine, thanks, and how are you?
Can you take your seats?
Thank you, ma'am.
Now, how is the weather today? Can you speak up so that the Sharma can hear what you're saying, Moni?
It is a little bit cold and a little bit short.
A little bit cold, a little bit hot, okay.
The weather today is cloudy.
Cloudy? Yes, Chantel?
The weather today is fine.
The weather today is fine, Tanasa?
The weather today is cold.
Now I'm hearing different responses from you learners. Now I'm confused. How is the weather? Okay. In which season are we now in? In which season?
Autumn.
Are we still in autumn?
No.
Which season are we in?
Winter.
Yes, you're already in winter. Now, boys and girls, today I'm going to learn about weather, and with me I have some slides that I want you to look at. Last thing in primary school? Yes, we have to talk about the weather. We are focusing on weather, elements. Elements of weather. I've heard you keep giving me different responses. Someone said the weather is cold. Someone said the weather is hot. Those are conditions of the what? Of the weather. Yes, but for us to see the conditions, we really need to talk about elements. Don't worry about the words, the new word, right? We are going to learn more on elements of weather. Yes. Now I have a picture with me here. Who can read what is on the screen? Yes, Chantel.
How is the weather today?
How is the weather today? It is sunny, class. How is the weather today? Who can tell me what they are seeing on the picture? Yes.
Sunny, cloudy.
No, just one, just one. Mention one so that you give others a chance. Yes.
Sunny.
Yes, it's sunny, meaning it will be very hot. And on a sunny day, what will be happening to the temperatures? Who can explain what will be happening to the temperatures when there is sun? Yes, Moni?
The temperatures will be high.
Can you speak up, please, boys and girls? Let's speak up.
The temperatures will be high.
Yes, when it is hot, the temperatures are very high. What else? What are the weather conditions? Can you see from the picture? Yes, Carlos, speak up.
Windy.
Yes, yes, there is windy. So we can say today it's windy. Yesterday it was sunny. What are the weather conditions? Oh, yes, Sharma?
Cloudy.
Cloudy. Yes, we can describe the weather as being what? Cloudy.
Yeah.
What else? What else? What else? Oh, what do we have? Makanaka?
Rainy.
Rainy. Rainy. Well done. Thank you so much for that. Now, let's move on to our next slide. Guys, look at this picture. It's sunny, but what's happening to the sunny? Who can explain what they are seeing on the picture? Yes, Munasha?
The sun is getting into the cloud.
And what can we say about it? How can we describe the weather? It's sunny on the first picture, yes, but yet the sun is getting into the cloud. What is that really happening?
It's cloudy.
It's cloudy, so we can say it's partially sunny and partially cloud. Isn't it, boys and girls?
Yes.
Yes, let's move on. You're just trying to describe different weather conditions. Look at the video now. Who can tell me what is happening on the video there? Yes, Chariro?
It is raining.
Yes, it's raining. And what else? What else can you see from the picture? Yes, Tanaswa?
It's windy and rainy.
It's windy and raining. Yes, let me put again the video so that you can clearly see it. Look, there's a storm, isn't it?
Yeah.
That's a storm. It's windy. At the same time, it's raining. is happening from that slide? I want new hands. Yes, Noctenda?
It's raining.
It's raining. Can you speak up, Noku?
It's raining.
Yes, it's raining. And it's raining heavily, isn't it?
Yes.
So, I've removed my answer from what you videos, from the pictures, from your own words. What is weather? Who can define? When you're asked, look at God, when you're asked to define, what are they asking you about? Yes.
What is?
Exactly. When you're asking to define, they're asking what is. So my question is, what then is weather? What is weather? Yes, so what you have seen from the pictures, from what you are experiencing in your everyday life, what is weather? Boys and girls, yes?
Weather is the state of atmosphere, fear of any given time or any place.
Okay, that's a one definition. Who else with a different definition? Yes, Maisie?
Weather is the atmospheric condition that is given at any particular time.
Okay, well done. Yes, Shantia?
Weather is the state of atmosphere at a given place or time.
Well done. Can you come again with that definition? I think I like that definition. Can you come again?
Weather is the state of atmosphere at a given place or time.
Yes, boys and girls, we all agree to that definition.
Yes.
Yes, we can all say that. Can we say it together?
Weather is the state of the atmosphere at a given time.
Yes, now let's look at the teacher's definition of weather. Who can read on the screen, Shama?
Weather is the state of atmosphere at any given time and place.
Yes. Another point there? Yes, Maisie?
Weather changes from time to time.
Yes, from the pictures that we have looked at, it was clear that weather changes from time to time. Remember, I said today we are going to focus on weather elements. Weather
elements.
Yes, but for us to be able to talk of weather elements, we had to describe the different weather
elements.
Weather conditions, isn't it?
Yes.
Now, let's move on to our next slide. We have some weather elements. Look at the screen. Well written, weather elements. Who can read the first weather element? Yes?
Rainfall.
Rainfall, yes, that's a weather element. I have seen most learners confusing elements and instruments. Right, let me write it down for you. Elements and
instruments.
Instruments. These are two different things. Elements and
instruments.
Yes, so the first element is rainfall. Remember, it is very important for a farmer to know the rainfall patterns. You cannot be a good farmer without knowing the rainfall patterns of your area, isn't it?
Yes.
Because in Zimbabwe, we have got different regions that receive different rainfall patterns. So for you to be a good farmer, you need to know the rainfall patterns. Who can read the next weather element? Yes.
Temperature.
Temperature. Yes, it's important for the farmer to know the temperature. Yes, temperature is another weather element. What else? What else?
Wind speed.
Wind. Can we come again?
Wind speed.
Wind speed. Yes. What else? What else? Wind speed. The farmers need to know about wind, isn't it?
Yes.
You can't just be a farmer who grows crops without knowing the wind patterns in your area. Yes, Moroni?
Humidity.
Humidity. What is humidity? When you talk of humidity, okay, let me put it this way. What will we be talking about when you talk of humidity? Yes, Tarina?
Humidity is the moisture in the air.
Yes, the amount of dampness of the air. You read it can be wet or you read it can be dry, isn't it? Right. Now that we have talked about the different weather elements, boys and girls, these elements have instruments that measure them. Are we together?
Yeah.
These elements have instruments. Right. Now, like I said before, we should not confuse elements and
instruments.
Elements and
instruments.
Yes. Elements are those that we talked about. And on instruments, these are gadgets that are used to measure the
elements.
Right. Let's move on and talk about the weather instruments now. For the weather elements. Right. On the board there. Look at the instruments on the board. Who can read the first instrument? Instrument. Right? Yes, Luarashe.
Rain gauge.
And rain gauge. Can you say it together, class?
Rain gauge.
Yes. What is measured by a rain gauge? Because a rain gauge is an instrument. Let's write it on the board. A rain
gauge.
Instrument to measure what? What is measured by rain? I can see some hands down. Yes, Tanatra?
A rain gauge measures rain.
Yes. So this is an instrument for?
Rainfall.
For rainfall, yes. Thank you very much for the correct answer. Another instrument there. Now, maybe before we pass on the rain gauge, let me make a few explanations. When we are measuring rainfall using a rain gauge, a rain gauge has an overflowing cylinder whereby when rain falls, it gets into the rain gauge through the funnel. Through the
funnel.
Yes, the funnel will be like this. So when rain falls, it will be dropping into the funnel. And it has got a measuring what? Cylinder to collect the overflowing rains. Are we together?
Yes.
Now, for this rainfall, for this rain gauge, it should be 1.5 meters from the ground. Are we together?
Yes.
Why is it supposed to be 1.5 meters from the ground? Yeah, put on your thinking caps, boys and girls. Why is it supposed to be 1.5 meters from the ground? Yes, Chantel?
It's supposed to feel the rain gauge.
Okay, I like your thinking. Not that bad. Well done, my kid. You have tried, yes, my sir?
It's supposed to be 1.5 meters because it wants to moisture the ground. It should moisture the ground.
Okay, well tried. You're in the right direction. Let's hear from Munashe.
A rain gauge is supposed to be 1.5 meters from the ground so that splashes of water do not get in.
Well done, give it your best for her. Yes, yes, that's the correct answer, my dear Chantel. Thank you so much for trying, my girls, isn't it? Now, we want to avoid splashes. We want to avoid
splashes.
Splashes, because when rain falls, it will be splashing, right? So we really want to measure the correct amount of rain for that day. Okay, now let's move on to another instrument. What do we have here? Oh, we want to do hands. Yes, Munashe the boy. A thermometer. What is measured by a thermometer? A thermometer is an instrument, remember?
Yes.
Measuring what?
Temperature.
But these days with the COVID issue. Okay, here. Temperature, 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 temperature. Is it the same temperature we are talking about?
No.
So, can you explain? Come on, guys, can you explain? At least teach your facilitator. Yes.
Temperature is used to measure heat.
To measure the amount of heat. Right. We said it is very important, remember, for the farmer to know the temperature patterns so that he or she will be able to know which type of crops to grow in that area, isn't it?
Yes.
There are some areas in Zimbabwe that receive lots of rainfall, isn't it? And there are some areas that receive low rainfall. So it is very important for the farmer to know the temperature patterns. Now, back to our thermometer. That's the thermometer. temperature. And remember, what color? What color is it supposed to be in? Yes, what color?
Red.
No.
Blue.
No. Okay, maybe it's a great question. Let me come again. I'm saying for this thermometer, when we have it at school, yeah? It's supposed to be at the Stevenson screen, isn't it? That's where the instruments are kept, at the Stevenson's screen. Right, so I'll take you to the Stevenson screen after the lesson to see the weather elements, isn't it?
Yes.
To go and see the different weather instruments that are measured by the different weather elements. Now I was asking the color of the Stevenson screen. Stevenson's screen, where we keep our thermometer. The color of the Stevenson screen where we keep our thermometer, because it doesn't need much heat, isn't it? So it needs to be protected. I was asking about color. Now the question is much clearer. I can see hands now. Yes, tell us.
It's supposed to be green.
No, not green.
Green.
No, it's supposed to be white. At least at school we learn new things every day, isn't it?
Yes.
Yes. The Stevenson screen is supposed to be painted in white. Why? Why white? And not black. And not green. And not blue. Why? Why white? Yes, Munasha?
It is white because white does not absorb heat.
Because white reflects heat, isn't it?
Yes.
Black absorbs. Don't you know that, boys and girls? You didn't know?
Yes.
Or at least you have learned something new today, isn't it?
Yes.
At least you have got something new to say about today. So we said the Stevenson screen where we keep our thermometer is painted in white. Because white reflects the heat. Now let's move on with our lesson, boys and girls. I have some more. Okay, before we move on to our next slide, which SI unit? SI unit is used for the rain gauge. Rain gauge. Is it measured in kilometers? When you talk of the SI unit, you're talking about kilometers or dollar sign? The SI unit for the rain gauge. Is it centimeters? Yeah, someone who said centimeters. Yes, Bradley.
The rain gauge is measured in.
Speak up, can you speak up?
The rain gauge is. The rain gauge measures in
millimeters. Can you come again?
Millimeters.
Millimeters. Yes. And not milliliters. No. This is wrong. But this one is
correct.
Okay, boys and girls.
Yes,
now let's move on with our slide. Now I've got the weather instruments, but this time I did not put the names. I want you to think. I want you to think. Isn't it? These are instruments. No names this time for you, so that you can provide the answers. Makanaka.
These are the instruments that measure the temperature.
No, I've changed the slide. Oh, you cannot see. Okay, you cannot see clearly? Yes, I've changed the slide. I've changed the slide. You want to ask it?
A cup, and a monitor.
Can you come again?
A cup,
That's why we are here. We are here to learn. At Kentman, we give learners a chance, isn't it?
Yes.
To learn and express themselves. Yes, can you come again, my dear girl?
A cup and a monitor.
Yes, well done. Can you say it together, class?
A cup and a monitor.
I can hear different answers. Cup, mama. Okay, it's supposed to be a cup and a monitor. Can you come again?
A cup and a monitor.
That's an instrument, a weather instrument used to measure what? A cup and a monitor. Cup and a monitor. Woo! Yes, Shama?
A cup and a monitor is used to measure wind speed.
Is it correct?
Yes.
Oh, you're the teacher, the facilitator. Is it correct?
Yes.
So we are saying a cup and a monitor. Cup and a
monitor.
Monitor measures.
Wind speed.
Wind speed, yes. Wind speed is very important. important for the farmer to know, isn't it?
Yeah.
Now we have another instrument. Another instrument there. I can see some hands. Yes, Takiwa?
It's a wind vane.
Do we have beakers?
Yes.
Is that a wind vane?
Yes.
Okay, now, it's an instrument used to measure what? What do we use this instrument for? A wind vane. A wind vane. It's an instrument to measure what? I want new hands. Yes, Chukwara Uni? Do we measure immediately using a wind vane?
No.
But thank you so much for trying. I like people who try. At least she has confidence. You hands. My dear, are we still together?
Yes.
Okay, fine. Shut down.
A wind vane is used to measure wind.
Wind? Wind what? Wind dogs? Wind cats?
No.
Wind what? Can you finish? You want some help?
Yes.
Can we ask Talia to help you? Talia, can you help?
A wind vane is used to measure wind direction.
Chantal, what did she say?
A wind vane is used to measure wind direction.
Well done, much better now. So, we have a wind vane to measure wind
direction.
To measure wind
direction.
Yes, and this arrow, and what are these points on the wind vane? What did we give to those points?
They are called...
She's thinking. Let's give it some time, yes.
There are things which we use to see
Yeah, you have an idea. Thank you for that. Yes. Tere?
It tells us the direction where the wind is going.
Yes, well done. Let me clap hands for him. At least they've clapped for you. Mm-hmm. Now, we are saying this arrow points to the direction where the wind is coming from. And these are called cardinal points. They are called
cardinal points.
Thank you. Yes. For those who do not have corrections. For those who do not have corrections. Answer number 1 to 6. Define weather. We talked about defining, right?
Yes.
When you ask me to define, you are asking to give a definition. What is weather? Number 2, list down 2 weather elements. Number 3, which instrument is used to measure rainfall? And what is the SI unit? Dash measures wind direction. Humidity is measured by an instrument called. Give us an answer. A cup anemometer is an instrument used to measure dash. After that, you underline your weather. Any assistance? Animals that get that is direct from the plants. Thank you very much, viewers, for watching the lesson. Hopefully you have enjoyed. Don't forget to like us on our Facebook page, and you can also follow us on Twitter and Instagram. It's bye-bye for now. Please don't write wrong corrections. I will not accept.